Nah, for this session, so we are going to talk about reading session, skill 3, and also skill 4. Yeah. Nah, so what is it about? Now, take a look at for this. Yeah, the following chart or the following table is the key information that you should remember. Yeah, about unstated detail. Yeah, unstated detail questions. Yeah, contoh. Jadi dalam reading itu ada yang namanya unstated detail questions, which is the questions like the following one. Yeah, which of the following is not stated? Which of the following is not mentioned? Which one of the following is not discussed? And all of the following are true except. Nah, pertanyaan-pertanyaan yang muncul pasti akan seperti ini. Yeah. So the question is how to answer the question. Yeah, how to answer the question? You need to choose. Yeah, you need to choose the keyword. Yeah, you need to point out to the keywords. Yeah, keywords in the questions, and then also scan. Yeah, the place that you can find out about the keyword. Yeah, and then read the sentences and look for the answer. Okay. Nah, so to make it short, yeah, to make it short, it's just like this. Now, skill 3 is all about unstated detail questions. Yeah, let me give you the example. Yeah, let me show you about this. Nah, so if there is a questions like this, yeah, if there is a one passage, so the first thing that you need to do is do not, yeah, okay, just remember about this one. Do not read the passage. Do not read the text. So the first step that you need to do is try to read the questions. Ya, bacalah pertanyaannya terlebih dahulu. Ya, nah seperti ini. Bacalah pertanyaan terlebih dahulu. Which of the following is not mentioned about Florida Keys? Nah, jadi jujur yang seperti ini itu memang it takes time. Butuh waktu untuk mencari jawabannya. Ya, so the first thing that you need to do is the keyword is Florida Keys. Ya. Which of the following is not mentioned? Manakah yang tidak disebutkan tentang Florida Keys? Nah, so we have this. The Florida Keys are blah, 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 blah. Nah, so take a look at for the keywords. Ada keywordsnya. Keywordsnya apa? Chain. So we have also chain here. So what else? That information that we can find out from the passage. That the Florida Keys, what is it? Something like... have this coral, yeah. Ini dia. Bravo, there is a coral. What else? The Florida Keys are in the shape of the arc. Nah, ada arc, kata arc di sini. Ada nggak kata, kalimat kata atau kata arc di situ? And then we can find out. Nah, ini dia. Arc. So, nah, setelah informasi itu ada semua, berarti kan, so we need to find out which is not mentioned, yeah. About the Florida Keys. So we can find out that the answer is for number one is Delta. Yeah, Florida Keys are not all inhabited. Jadi, so the most important thing is you need to find out the keyword. Yeah, lihatlah keywordnya. Okay. Nah, yang seperti ini memang it takes time. Itu butuh waktu memang karena ini benar-benar menguras waktu kita untuk mencari mana yang benar atau mana yang tidak benar ya. So what about number two? Which of the following is not true about US highway? Nah, ini juga butuh waktu ya. So which is not true. Nah, so this is the point. Which is not true about the US highway one. Nah, so we need to write down about US highway one. So this is about this one. And then try to take a look at four the keywords. So we have this one, the overseas highway. So what about in here? So we have also the overseas highway. So what about another one? Yeah, bridges. Yeah, it has more than 40 bridges. So what about this? 42 bridges. Yeah, 42 bridges. It is the same thing with the more than 40 bridges. So we have also for number Delta. For Delta, Delta is it connects Miami and Key West. It connects Miami from Miami to Key West. So we have this. Nah, ini juga ada nih. Which is not. Manakah yang tidak? Nah, yang tidak berarti jawabannya adalah of course. So we have this. Yeah, it joins all the island. in the Florida Keys. Ya, jadi sekali lagi, so you need to figure out about something like the keywords. Ya, keywordsnya yang harus kita perhatikan. Ya, so please do not read all of the sentences. Do not read all of the text. Jangan pernah membaca teksnya. Ya, bacalah apa? Bacalah kalimat yang di sini. Ya, kalimat pilihannya Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, dan Delta. Ya, memang ini butuh waktu memang, tetapi minimal kalian tahu. So this is the way how can you read the answer or answer the questions. Okay, so lanjut lagi ke soal selanjutnya. Ya, coba kita lihat lagi. So please pay attention. Kita setelah kita latihan, kita langsung ke soalnya. Okay, ya. Berapa soal-soal sedikit saja ya. So take a look at for the exercise 3 ya. So we have this. Ya, passage 1 is all about question 2 and also sorry, 1 and 2. Ya. Nah, so remember when we want to answer the question, so you need to read the question first and second one read the text. Ya, which of the following not true about systolic blood pressure. Yeah. So keyword is systolic blood pressure. So I will give you 1 minute to answer 2 questions, number 1 and also number 2. Coba ada yang bisa menjawab atau tidak? Coba. Coba bisa, ada yang bisa? Oke. Okay. So we have this. Which of the following is not true about systolic blood pressure? So you need to make a keyword. Systolic blood pressure. And then, so what about number two? The questions for number two. Which of the following is not stated about diastolic pressure? Okay. Number one, and then also number two. Who can answer the questions? So please. Write down on the chat box. Anyone can answer the questions? Yang bisa jawab? Give you 1 minute. 1 minute for these questions. 2 questions. Systolic and also diastolic. Yeah. So you do not need to read all of them, but just read the keywords. Okay, anyone? Systolic.
Number one is delta.
Number one is delta. Okay, just take it first, delta. So yes. What about number two? Number two. Okay. Okay, so take a look at for number one first. Yeah, so the blood pressure has 2 components, systolic and diastolic. Okay, so take a look at for the keyword. So the keyword is systolic blood pressure. So take all of the information, and then so you need to find out which one is not true about that. Yeah. So let's say one of the example, you said that delta hypertension exists when the systolic pressure is below 140. Now, so take a look, hypertension. Yeah, just find out hypertension, and we have this hypertension exists when ini dia. Nah, hypertension borderline systolic pressure between 140. Dia bilang di sini exists when systolic pressure is below. Nah, padahal systolic pressure between dia itu exists antara between 140 and 160. So it is not true, yeah, because below, dia bilang below, padahal dia di tengah-tengah ya, dia di antara 140 dan 160. So the answer is delta. Ya, normal systolic measure is 120-140. Coba lihat normalnya, normal blood systolic. Nah ini, ya, yeah, so this is true, benar, ya. Tapi yang salah hanyalah delta. Ya, so the point is trying to find out the keywords. So what about number two? So it's all about diastolic pressure. Anyone can answer for number two? Yeah. So you do not have to need to read all of the text, but just pay attention for the keywords. Not stated. Manakah yang tidak disebutkan tentang diastolic pressure? Which of the following is not stated about diastolic pressure? Diastolic pressure itu di mana informasinya? Diastolic, this one. Okay. Diastolic pressure is bla 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 bla. And then what else? Pasti di sini nih informasinya ya. So the information is here. And then also we have, hanya di situ ya. Which is not stated about diastolic pressure. What about number two? Can you get the answer?
I think it's delta again, sir.
To delta, sir, from Indri. Okay, so take a look at for delta. Diastolic measurement of 140 is normal. Dia bilang ini normal, ya. Coba kita langsung ke kalimat normal, kata ko normal. Karena normal ada di sini. But kalau kita scan, if we scan the sentence, so there is no diastolic. This is only systolic, systolic, and also systolic. So, nah, so where can we can find out about that one? So we have this, ya. Diastolic measurement of 140 is normal. Nah, kita lihat di sini. So we need to, it is blood pressure reading to given. Okay. Normal blood is pressure 100 when the systolic pressure is high. Hypertension, systolic pressure between, okay, the systolic measurement of 140 is normal. Nah, between the beats and that. And find out that, okay, which is not stated. Nah, ini dibilang ya, bahwa measurement of normalnya 140. But there is no information about delta in this text. Ya, jadi normalnya hanya di sini nih. Jadi nggak ada tentang diastolik. Ya, yang ada itu hanya systolic. Nah, okay. So the answer for number two is delta. Okay. And then, so we go to the second one, the second passage, passage two. So we have for number three until number four. Ya, take a look at for this. Ya, ada soalnya ini. Ya, it's all about airlines. Yeah. So number three until number four, and please pay attention for question first. Yeah, read the question first, and then so you go to the text. Yeah. All of the following are mentioned about Pan American Airlines, except. Nah, ini kecuali semua yang disebutkan kecuali. Nah, yeah. And what about number four? Which of the following is not true about Pan Am Moon's flight? Nah, which is not true? Nah, ini memang it takes time. Ya, butuh waktu ya untuk membaca yang seperti ini. But the most important thing is you need to read the keywords. Ya. So what about number three and number four? I'm going to give you the time for 1 minute. 3. So it is about Pan America Airlines, one of the tremendous aircraft in America, which is called Pan American Airlines. Yeah, so yeah, we have this one, the message from Kayla Kalika. Yeah, Kalika A for number 3 is Alpha. Yeah, well, something that not mentioned about American Island. It started business on 1960s. Started business, so take a look at for the word business is there. Oke, okay. Memang ada 1960 di sini, tapi dia memulai bisnisnya di tahun 1960. Ya, 1960. Except, sekali lagi ya, except, kecuali. Ya. So there's nothing to do about nah, ini dia. Unfortunately, Pan American company is no longer in business. It never got to the moon. Nah, so it's all about the mission of the plans to the moon. Yeah. So it is stated that it started business in 1980s. Ya, ini dimulai di 34 Delta. Okay, ya, phone number 1 is Alpha. Ya, so what about Bravo, Charlie, and Delta? Ya, nah, ini ada semua informasinya pada teks yang di atas. Went out of the business, maksudnya no longer. Nah, ini dia. And then it kept some people long waiting list. Ya, nah, ada nggak kalimat di situ? When it went out of business. Waiting list, ada juga nih waiting list. Nah, so receive request for the first flight to the moon. Ya, first flight to the moon, request first flight to the moon. Nah, ini dia. Ya, jadi yang tidak ada itu hanyalah yang it started business on. Okay. So, what about number 4? Number 4 is Delta. Ada yang bilang Delta Mahesa, stated that Delta. Yeah, number 4 is Delta, which is not true about Pan Am's moon's flight. Nomor 4 Delta. Jadi kita bisa lihat di sini. Yeah, Pan Am waiting list had only a few names on it. Nah, jadi ada kalimat, ada kata few names on it. Nah, padahal ya padahal nah ini dia ya so the list ya jadi kalau kita bilang di sini ini more than 90,000 names for the list ya for the first lunar flight so nah ini dia Delta. Ya, manakah yang tidak ada ya, yang tidak benar tentang informasi di atas. Pan Am's. Jadi so you need to make a keyword Pan Am's moon flight. Nah, Pan Am. This is the answer. Ya, which is not true about Pan Am, so we have Delta. Okay. Nah. Okay, and then we go to okay. We go to the next one. Yang disebut dengan apa namanya? Itu untuk unstated details. So what about a skill 4? Nah, for skill 4, so we go to the skill 4, it is called implied details questions. Ya, jadi ini sesuatu yang detail, yang implied meaning. Implied itu maksudnya tersirat. Ya, bukan tersurat, tetapi tersirat. Yeah. So what you are going to do, try to see, find out the implication, find out the hidden meaning. Yeah. For instance, so we have this. Coba dilihat nomor satu. Yeah. Number one until number two, so there is one questions. So there is one text or passage. Yeah. Nah, so take a look at this. Nah, kalau ada kalimat seperti ini, ya kita langsung saja ke keywordsnya. It is implied in the passage that if the tree has 100 wide bands and 100 narrow bands. Nah, langsung mata kita langsung ke kalimat di atas, ya. So 100, tidak 100 di situ, ya. So we have this, ya. One light color. Nah, what color? We have this. And also narrow band. Ya. So it is implied in the passage that its tree has 100 wide bands and 100 narrow. Then it is what happened? Ya, what happened? And it is a century old. Nah, jawabannya adalah century old. Kenapa bisa kita tahu one century old? Karena di sini ada kalimat. Ya, each year tree produces a ring that is composed one light. Jadi one light itu istilah dari one light, it means 100. Ya, one dark 100. Nah, jadi bisa kita lihat jawabannya adalah the answer is this one, alpha, a century old. Century light atau implied meaning dari this one light. Ya. Kalau kita lihat lagi di kalimat di atas, there is no information about that. Ya. Kemudian, so what about number two? For number two, we have it can be inferred from the passage that cells, nah ini ada kata cells, cells do not grow. Nah, so what does it mean? Apa implikasinya? The cells do not grow. Jadi cari kata cells. Yeah, so you find out here, no cells are produced during the harsh winter and summer months. So we can find out that can be inferred from the passage that cells do not grow. Nah, di sini ada kata cells do not grow. Cells do not produce ataupun berkembang begitu ya, berproduksi ya, during extreme. Nah, extreme heat or cold. Nah, heat it means summer. Ya. Heat it means summer, and then cold it means harsh. So it's just like the similar meaning, ya. Jadi itu yang disebut dengan implied meaning, ya. Jadi memang harus hati-hati. So you need to be careful about in answering the questions. Nah, langsung ke ini dia ya. So take a look at for this one. The following chart outline the key information that you should remember about implied detail questions. Ya, pertanyaannya pasti akan seperti ini. It is implied in the passage that blah 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 blah. It can be inferred. Nah, inferred, implied, most likely, and what probably happened. Biasanya kalimatnya begini. Ya, so how to answer the question? This is the way. How can you answer the question? Choose the keyword, ya, yeah, again and again. So you need to pay attention for the keywords, ya. Yeah. Scan and then look for the best answer, ya. Yeah. Coba kita langsung ke soal dua soal yang bisa kita cek di sini. Nah, it's all about the sea towers. Yeah. Ini ada three questions. Passage one for questions one until questions three. Ya, yeah, number one until number three. Ya, yeah. Coba kita bareng-bareng coba dilihat nomor satu sampai nomor tiga. So what is the answer? For number one, so you need to find out the keyword. Sea towers is probably blah 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 blah. Manakah yang benar kalimatnya pada pilihan di bawah? The sea towers. ada lagi nggak informasi tentang Sea Towers? Berarti jawabannya ada pada kalimat pertama, in the first sentence, atau pada paragraf tersebut. Sea Towers is probably bla 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 bla. So, it can be inferred from the passage that Chicago, Chicago, and then so your eyes goes to Chicago. Manakah informasi yang tersembunyi di situ, yang sesuai dengan pilihan di sini? So, what about number three? Number three juga seperti itu ya. Upper level doors close because. Nah, open. Open, close, level. Close, sea towers. Ada tidak? Nah, ini dia. Doors, top, the building, open and close. Oh, just give you the keywords. So please find the best answer for number one, two, and also number three.
Number one, see, sir.
Number one is?
See.
Okay. Number one, Charlie. Ada yang bilang Delta. Ferdian said it is Delta. Charlie or Delta for number one. One, tower is probably that until 19. Sea Tower has the tallest building in the world with more than 100 stories. Stories itu maksudnya lantai ya. Lantai. Sea Towers. Oke. Okay. Coba ada yang lain? Nomor 1D kata Ferdian. Siapa tadi bilang tadi? Nobertus bilang Charlie.
Chip. Yes.
Probably taller than any other building. Any other building. Oh, Mahesa Wulan bilang bravo. Ah, oke, okay. Gimana tuh? Ya, ada Charlie, ada Delta, ada Bravo, ya. Yeah. So, nah, seperti itu memang it's just like you need to read the sentence. Ya, yeah. Read the passage or the text, ya, yeah, carefully. Ya, yeah. It is ada di sini. Oke, ada yang bilang kenapa jawabannya Charlie? Nobertus, maybe would you like to explain why the answer is Charlie, taller than any other building.
Karena di kalimat pertama itu until 1996 the Sears Towers was the tallest building in the world with more than 100 stories.
Yes, yeah.
Kalau misalnya dipilih still the highest building in the world, untuk sekarang mungkin itu bukan lagi menjadi gedung tertinggi di dunia.
Yes, okay. So we can find out, yeah. Delta. Of course, incorrect, right? Delta pasti salah.
Yes, sir.
Ya, kalau Charlie taller than any other building. Nah, taller than any other building. Lebih tinggi dari building yang lain. Ya, ini kan disebutkan until sampai 1996. Kalau sampai 1996, apakah ada kalimat waktu di situ? Nggak ada. Nah. Jadi mungkin Charlie it is not incorrect. So what about another one? Coba yang lain. Yang lain gimana? Mahesa atau Wulan, you said that it is Bravo.
Kata kunci ada di kalimat pertama, Pak.
Kata kuncinya pada di kalimat
pertama itu.
Kalimat pertama.
Was the tallest building in the world.
Nah, oke. Okay. Jadi, so it's just like implied. Lagi-lagi ya, implied meaning that we can get from the statement. Contoh, until 1969, the Sears Tower was the tallest building in the world. Ya, sampai tahun 1996, dialah yang paling tinggi. Nah, artinya sampai tahun 1996 dia adalah paling tinggi. Berarti lebih dari berarti 1997 ya. Lebih dari itu dia sudah tidak yang tertinggi lagi. Berarti kan tahun 1996 dia yang paling tinggi memang. Tetapi kalau sudah mungkin 1998 mungkin ada yang lebih tinggi lagi. Ya. So, we can find out that from the statement the Sea Tower is probably no longer ya, no longer the tallest building in the world. Ya, Bang, kata kuncinya ada pada, nah ini dia, pada apa namanya, pada kalimat pertama. Ya, nah itu dia. So the answer is bravo. Tidak lagi menjadi yang tertinggi di dunia. Ya, karena dia bilang until this one was the tallest. Berarti kan setelah itu berarti ada yang lebih tinggi lagi. Ya, so what about number two? Coba, thank you Mahesa. Ya, coba Wulan juga terima kasih. We go to another one. Nah, selanjutnya, what can we infer from the passage in Chicago? That Chicago, bla 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 bla. Ada apa yang bisa kita ambil informasi tentang Chicago? Chicago was the nickname is the Windy City. It's located in Chicago. Apa yang bisa kita info yang bisa kita ambil dapat dari Chicago? Oke. Okay. Oh, nomor 2 Delta. Number 2 Delta. Ya. Yeah. What can we get from information about the word the city is called Chicago, located in Chicago. Chicago ya, yeah. Chicago's name whose nickname is the Windy City, ya, yeah. Kota yang banyak dengan anginnya. So Delta, ya, yeah. So Chicago usually has a lot of wind. Nah, ini dia. Ya, yeah, Windy City. Ya, yeah, disebut dengan Windy City. So it means that Chicago has a lot of wind. Okay, good. Thank you, Herdian. Next, for number 3. What about number 3?
Check, please, sir.
3 with the blue one. It is implied that upper level doors in the sea towers open and close because kenapa dia bisa naik dan turun?
Charlie.
Oke, okay, nomor 3. Charlie. Oke. Okay. Coba kita lihat. So okay, nomor 3 Charlie from Dimas. Ya, yeah, Satri juga bilang Charlie. Oke. Okay. For number 3 we have why the doors upper level and open and close? Why? Kenapa dia bisa terbuka dan tertutup? Ya, yeah, so tentu balik lagi kita lihat lagi ininya. Okay. On the windy day, the top of the building can move back. Inside the doors of the building, open and close. Water sink closes back and forth. Ya, apa yang menyebabkan tertutup dan terbuka? Ya. So, jawabannya apa? Number 3, Charlie, the building moves in the wind. The building. So, okay. So on the windy day, the tallest building can move back. The doors at the top building open and close on the windy day. Berarti siapa yang menggerakkan? Yeah, the building moves in the wind. Nah, yeah. Because the building moves in the wind. So the answer is Charlie. Yeah. So this is all about the something like implied meaning. Yeah. Buat teman-teman, so you need to read careful about the passage, ya. Jadi memang butuh waktu memang ya, apalagi yang reading, karena memang soal-soal reading itu ada yang tricky. Nah, so you need to be careful in reading for the questions. Baik, buat teman-teman semuanya ada yang mau ditanya mungkin? Gimana, ada yang mau ditanya? Jadi nanti akan ada lagi materi selanjutnya, yaitu skill ke 5 dan 6 ya. Dimana skill ini 5 dan 6 ini nanti akan saya berikan videonya ya, dimana videonya itu sudah saya record dan teman-teman bisa mempelajarinya di situ. Oke, okay. Baik. Ada yang mau ditanya lagi? Ya, ada lagi yang mau ditanya mungkin? Is there any other questions? Gak ada? Cukup berarti ya?
Iya, tidak ada, Pak.
Oke, okay. Ya, kalau begitu nanti saya cukupkan dulu untuk kali ini. Again and again, thank you very much for your attention. Thank you for joining this class. Thank you for Charlie, Albertus Puang, Dimas, Indri, dan yang lain ya yang telah masuk ke link ini. Semoga selalu diberikan kesehatan dan kesugihan di dalam hidupnya. Ya, saya pamit undur diri. Thank you very much for your attention. Class dismissed and assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam. Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.